Hello dear students, welcome to lecture 8 on the chapter Ray Optics and Optical Instruments. Students, in lecture 7, we discussed about lens, types of lens, and then we derived an expression for lens maker's formula. In this lecture, we are going to discuss on power of a lens, magnification of lens, image formation by convex and concave lens, and finally we will be discussing on combination of thin lenses. Now let us discuss all these points one by one. Power of a lens. Power of a lens is the measure of convergence or divergence. Convergence or divergence which lens produces in the light fall on it. That means it tells about the convergence or divergence of the ray of light passing through it is called power of lens. Okay, now let us see the definition of power of lens. The tangent of the angle by which lens converges or diverges a beam of light falling at a unit distance from the optic center is called power of lens. Okay, now let me clear this by explaining with the help of ray diagram. Parallel ray is incident on convex lens, and after this ray passing through the lens, it bends and passes along this, and it passes through the principal focus. Okay, it is making some angle with the direction of incident ray. That angle I have taken it as delta. Okay, if this angle is delta, even this angle will be delta. And when you see this, it's a right angle triangle. Now with the help of this, we can define power of lens. The tangent of the angle by which the tangent of the angle, okay, this is the tangent of the angle by which lens converges. Okay, it converges in case of convex lens or diverges in case of concave lens. A beam of light falling at a unit distance from the optic center. It is falling at a unit distance from the optic center is called power of lens. Okay, now let us give mathematical relation for power of lens. Consider a ray of light is incident parallel to the principal axis at a height h from the optic center. Okay, consider a parallel incident light which is parallel to principal axis at a height h from the optic center. The ray bends by an angle delta and it passes through principal focus. Okay, after passing through lens, it bends by an angle delta, making with direction of incident ray, and then it passes through principal focus. If f is the focal length of the lens, then OF is equal to f. Now from figure, see, when you look at the figure, this is right angle triangle, right? This is right angle triangle. From the definition of power, tan delta is equal to h divided by f. Okay, this is opposite and this one is adjacent. By the definition of tan function, that is tan delta is equal to h by f, where h is height and f is focal length. Okay, this is the expression for power of lens. Suppose if height h is equal to unit length, if h equal to 1, and putting the value of h equal to 1 in this equation, then the above equation becomes tan delta is equal to 1 by f. Okay, this is one equation, and we know that power of lens is given by p is equal to tan delta. Okay, just now we had shown that tan delta equal to 1 by f, putting that value in this equation. Finally, we can write it as p is equal to 1 by f. Power of lens is equal to reciprocal of focal length. Okay, even with the help of this equation, we can define power of lens. Power of lens is defined as reciprocal of its focal length. The SI unit for power of lens is diopter, and it is symbolically represented by capital D. Now let us define one diopter. Okay, with the help of this equation we can define SI unit of power of lens. Okay, if focal length f is equal to 1 meter, then the power of lens is said to be 1 diopter. Power of lens is 1 diopter if its focal length is 1 meter. Okay, this is the definition for 1 diopter or SI unit of power of lens. Okay, now with the help of this equation, we can write two statements. First one, a lens of shorter focal length, that means a lens having small focal length, bends the incident light more. That means if the lens has shorter focal length, the power of lens will be more and it bends the incident ray more. Second point, power of lens is positive for a converging lens and negative for diverging lens. That means power of lens is positive for convex lens and negative for concave lens. Okay, these two points are important one you need to remember. Next, rays to be considered for image formation. Okay, usually we will be talking about image formation, right? Okay, we have to consider certain rays, some rays, for the formation of image. Let us see which all rays has to be considered. First one, a ray of light passing parallel to the principal axis, after refraction passes through second principal focus, that is F dash in case of convex lens, or appears to diverge from the first principal focus in case of concave lens. Okay, we have shown here the ray of light passing parallel to principal axis in both the cases, and after refraction it passes through second principal focus in case of convex lens, or appears to diverge from first principal focus in case of concave lens. Okay, this is first ray. Second one, a ray of light passing through the optic center of lens passes undeviated after refraction. Okay, here area of light passing through optic center, passes undeviated. See, there is no change in the direction of light. Undeviated after refraction. Okay, this is second ray. Third one, a ray of light passing through first principal focus, or appears to meet at second principal focus in case of concave lens, emerges parallel to the principal axis after refraction. See, a ray of light passing through first principal focus in case of convex lens, or appears to meet, okay, I have not shown here, I have shown it only in convex lens, and emerges parallel to principal axis after refraction. Okay, we have to consider these three rays, and for image formation at least we should consider two of them. Next, magnification by a lens. Okay, already we have studied magnification in the topic mirrors, and will not be taking much time in defining this. Directly we will be going with the definition, that is, the ratio of size of the image to the size of the object is called magnification, and it is mathematically given by m equal to h dash divided by h is equal to v divided by u, where h dash is size of the image, that is height of the image, and h is size of the object or height of the object, that is equal to v by u, where u is image distance and v is object distance. Even magnification can be expressed as m equal to f minus v divided by f, and m equal to f divided by f plus u. Okay, by this we come to know that even magnification can be expressed in terms of focal length and image distance, or It can be expressed in terms of focal length and object distance. If M is positive, then the image formed by the lens is virtual and erect. That is, if magnification is positive, then the image formed by the lens is virtual and erect. If magnification is negative, then the image formed by the lens is real and inverted. Okay, this is brief description about magnification of lens. Next, image formation by a convex lens. Okay, now let us see how the images are formed by convex lens when the object is placed at different positions in front of lens. First one, when the object is placed at infinity. Okay, if the object is placed at infinity, the rays from the object when passes through convex lens will converge or will meet at principal focus. That means image is formed at principal focus, that is V equal to F. What is the nature? The nature of the image is real, inverted and diminished. Diminished means small. Okay, since it is inverted and small, hence magnification is less than 1. Next, second position. When the object is placed beyond 2F, when it is placed beyond 2F, then image is formed between F and 2F. Image is formed between F and 2F. And what is the nature? The nature of the image is real and inverted. What do you mean by real? The image is formed at the other side of the lens. Then we call it as a real image and it is inverted. It is inverted and diminished. Nature of the image is real, inverted and diminished. Since the image is smaller than the object, hence magnification is less than 1. For third position, when the object is placed between F and 2F, the rays passing through the lens, they meet beyond 2F. That means image is formed beyond 2F. And the nature is real, inverted and enlarged. Enlarged means the image size of the image is bigger than the size of the object. Okay, nature of the image is real, inverted and enlarged. And magnification is greater than 1. Next, for fourth position, when the object is placed at focus. Okay, when it is placed at principal focus, image is formed at infinity. The nature of the image is real, inverted and highly enlarged. Hence, magnification is very, very greater than 1. For fifth position, when the object is placed between F and O, that is principal focus and optic center, the image is formed front of mirror, that means at the side of object. And nature of image is virtual, erect and enlarged. See, we can see this one here. It is right on the side of object. It is virtual, erect, enlarged. Hence, magnification is greater than 1. Okay, these are the image formation by convex lens when a ray of light passes through convex lens. Now, let us discuss how the image is formed by concave lens. For all the position of the object, okay, object is here. When you place the object anywhere, in case of concave lens always produces virtual, erect and diminished. Concave lens always produces virtual, erect and diminished image within the principal focus on the same side of the object. See, it is formed at the same side of the object. Okay, this is the image formation by concave lens. Combination of lenses. Two or more lenses are used either in contact or with a gap between them for following reasons. First one, to increase the magnification of the image. Second one, to increase the sharpness of the image. Third one, to increase the field of view. Fourth one, to erect the final image. Fifth one, to obtain diverging or converging lenses of desired magnification. Okay, for these five reasons, the lenses are combined. Now let us derive an equation for equivalent focal length when the lenses are combined or when they are in contact with each other. Consider two lenses A and B of focal length F1 and F2 respectively. And these two are placed in contact with each other with common principal axis. Let O be the object placed on common principal axis. The two rays of light from the object O incident on the combination after refraction through the combination meet actually at point I on the principal axis. Okay, this is the description about the ray diagram. And V is the distance between the object and the center of the combination. V1 is the distance between the P and I1, and V is distance between P and I. Let O be the object, I is the image, U is the object distance, and V is image distance. The formation of final image I of an object O can be shown in two steps. First one, refraction through the lens A, that means in the absence of second lens. In the absence of lens B, I1 is the real image formed corresponding to object O. Then by using lens formula, we can write as 1 by V1 minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Okay, we know lens formula, right? 1 by F is equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. Here, V1 is the image distance in the absence of second lens B, and U is the object distance, and F1 is the focal length of lens A. Let this equation be 1. Second step, refraction through lens B. Okay, in the absence of lens A, I1 acts as a virtual object and I is final image formed. Again, by using lens formula for lens B, we can write as 1 by V minus 1 by V1 is equal to 1 by F2. Let this equation be 2. Okay, in this equation, V is image distance and V1 is object distance. Okay, since I1 acts as virtual object, therefore V1 is object distance. Now add equation 1 and 2. We get here 1 by V1 will get cancelled with each other, and finally we get 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. Let this equation be 3. Suppose if the combination of the lenses are replaced by a single lens, and that lens is called equivalent lens of equivalent focal length F, then by using lens formula we get 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Let this equation be 4. Now from equation number 3 and 4, we can show that 1 by F is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. Okay, this is the expression for equivalent focal length when two lenses are in contact with each other. By this we can say that the reciprocal of focal length of the equivalent lens is equal to the sum of the reciprocal of the focal lengths of lenses in contact. Okay, this is the expression for two thin lenses when they are placed in contact with each other. Okay, let us discuss few important points. First one, the above formula is valid for any number of thin lenses in contact. If the lenses of focal length F1, F2, F3 and so on are in contact,
Then effective focal length or equivalent focal length is given by 1 by f effective is equal to 1 by f 1 plus 1 by f 2 plus 1 by f 3 plus and so on. Second point, if p1, p2, p3 and so on are the powers of lenses in contact, then effective power of the combination is equal to p1 plus p2 plus p3 and so on. For finite number of lenses, each of which produces magnification m1, m2, m3 and so on, their combination produces magnification of total magnification is equal to m1 into m2 into m3 and so on. Okay, these points are important one related with combination of thin lenses. Thank you, students, and we'll be discussing some more topics in the next lecture.